In this video, we will discuss about kinematic equations for uniformly accelerated motion or constant accelerated motion using graphical method. Question will come like this: obtain equations of motion for constant acceleration using graphical method. The equations relating to displacement x, time taken t, initial velocity v0, final velocity v, acceleration a are called equations of motion. First, let us deduce the equation of motion v equal to v0 plus at. This is a relation between initial velocity, final velocity and uniform acceleration and t. We know from the vt graph the slope of the curve, the slope of the straight line. This is your vt graph. In the x axis we have taken time and in the y axis we have taken velocity. So it is vt graph, conventionally called vt graph. And this is the initial velocity v0 and this is the final velocity v. So this distance is your v and this distance is v0. So this distance will be equal to v minus v0. This length will be equal to v minus v0 and this length is equal to t. So the slope of the straight line AB is equal to the acceleration a. So acceleration a will be equal to slope of the straight line, that means BC divided by AC, that is equal to v minus v0 divided by t. So if a equal to v minus v0 divided by t, then v minus v0 will be equal to 80. So v will be equal to v0 plus 80. So this is the first equation of motion. Now let us deduce the second equation of motion, that is x is equal to v0 t plus half at square using graphical method. We know area of the vt graph gives displacement. So if we calculate the area under this vt graph, then it will give you the expression for displacement. The area under this graph AB, under this line AB, is equal to the area of this rectangle, the area of this triangle plus area of this rectangle. And area of this triangle is equal to half into base into height. That means half into the base length is equal to t and the height length is equal to v minus v0. And the area of this rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Your length is equal to, let us say, v0 and breadth is equal to t. So area of this rectangle ACDO is equal to v0 into t. So you can find out displacement if you calculate the area of this triangle ABC plus area of this rectangle ACDOA. So area between the instants 0 and t is equal to x, that is equal to area of the triangle ABC plus area of the rectangle OABD, and that is equal to not OABD, that is equal to OACD, that is OACD, it is not BD, that is OACD. So that is equal to half into base into height. Area of the triangle ABC is equal to half into base into height, that is equal to half into base is t and height is t v minus v0, and area of this rectangle is equal to length into breadth, that is equal to v0 into t. So this will be equal to half into v minus v0 into t plus v0 into t. But we have deduced that v minus v0 is equal to 80. So x will be equal to half. In place of v minus v0, we can write 80. So here 80, again t. So it is equal to half 80 square plus v0 into t. So rearranging the terms, x will be equal to v0 into t plus half 80 square. So this is the second equation of motion. Now we will deduce the third equation of motion, that is v square is equal to v0 square plus 2ax. We have deduced that x is equal to half into v minus v0 into t plus v0 into t. That is, the displacement is equal to area of the triangle, that is half into base into height, that is half into t into v minus v0 plus v0 into t. We have deduced it. So, x will be equal to half into vt minus half into v0 into t plus v0 into t. So, if you make the subtraction here, this will be equal to half v0 into t. So, x will be equal to, if you write this like v plus v0 divided by 2 into t, then here v plus v0 divided by t, this will be your average velocity. So, the displacement will be equal to average velocity into time. You have to remember this formula. That is, the displacement is equal to average velocity into time. Again, you have to remember this formula also. Average velocity is equal to v plus v0 divided by 2. That is, final velocity plus initial velocity divided by 2. Again, we have reduced the relation v equal to v0 plus 80. So, t will be equal to v minus v0 divided by t. Now, in this equation, x equal to v average into t, you put the value of t here and the value of v average, that is v plus v0 by 2 here. So, if x is equal to v average into t and v average is equal to v plus v0 divided by 2 and t equal to v minus v0 divided by a. So, when you solve this, this will be equal to v square minus v0 square divided by 2a. So, by cross multiplication, v square will be equal to v0 square plus 2ax. So, this is the third equation of motion. So, you have to remember these three equations motion, equations of motion, v equal to v0 plus 80, x equal to v0t plus half a t square, and v square is equal to v0 square plus 2ax, which are called kinematic equations for rectilinear motion for constant acceleration. Here you have taken the acceleration to be constant. It is rectilinear because it is moving in straight line. We have discussed about rectilinear motion in previous video, and these are called kinematic equations. Why kinematic? Because force is not involved here. So you have to remember these three formulas. Again, you have to also remember the formula. The displacement x is equal to average velocity into time, and also you have to remember the formula: average velocity is equal to initial velocity plus initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2, or final velocity plus initial velocity divided by 2. So in this case, we have taken at time t equal to 0, x equal to 0. But if at time t equal to 0, the position of the body is not 0, that is x equal to x0, suppose say, then we have to replace x by x minus x0. We have to take the subtraction of x0 from x. So, in this equation for displacement, you have to write x minus x0 instead of x. So, this will be, this equation will be x minus x equal to x0 plus v0t plus half a t square. This equation is for the position when the time at time t equal to 0, x equal to x0. Similarly, when at time t equal to 0, x equal to x0, we have to replace here x minus x0. So, we will get another equation, v square is equal to v0 square plus 2a into x minus x0. So, in this video, we have discussed about the kinematic equations for rectilinear motion or straight line motion for constant acceleration or uniform acceleration by using graphical method. In the next video, we will discuss about the kinematic equations for rectilinear motion for constant acceleration using calculus method. So, thank you.